So friends, now we are going to see about pteridophytes and its life cycle. So in this video, we are going to cover about what are pteridophytes, characteristics of pteridophytes, its morphology, reproduction, its homosporous and heterosporous nature, about the megaspore and microspore, gametophytes of the pteridophytes, and fertilization, zygote, embryo, and as well as life cycle and alternations of the generations. Coming to the first part, about the general characters, means what the pteridophytes will look like and why we call it as pteridophyte. That is very important in this general characters. So coming to the pteridophytes, we call it as ferns. So plant with feather-like leaves. So pteron means feathers, phyton means plants. Means the plant's leaves which looks like feathers, because of that we call it as pteridophytes. Coming to the next, these are the vascular cryptogams. Cryptogams with vascular system. So these include primitive living and fossil vascular plants represented by 400 genera and 10,500 species, living as well as fossil. So the plant body is sporophytic, differentiated into stem, root as well as the leaves. So the mature sporophyte is nutritionally independent of gametophyte. So in this picture we can able to see this is the pteridophyte. So the plant with feather-like leaves. So the leaves are being looking like a feathers. And coming to the next. So much variation in the form of size and habitat. So the some annuals are Azolla, Salvinia. Two large perennial trees are Angiopteris. So coming to the most of the living pteridophytes are terrestrial. So Ciliotum, Sagellina. And next we have Lycopodium. So these are the three pteridophytes. And next, some members are aquatic. Azolla, Marsilia, Isoetes, Salvinia. So few are xerophytes. Selaginella, Rupestreus. So this is Azolla, this is Marsilia, this is Salvinia, and this is Isoetes. And next, stem and roots have a permanent growing apex. Most of them having herbaceous stem. So the leaves are nothing but they are scaly in equistem, small sessile in Lycopodium and Selaginella. The large petiolate compounds in the ferns are being present. So in this picture we can able to see the leaves in the pteridophytes. So these leaves are scaly leaves. Here we have the sessile leaves. Here we have the petiolate leaves. And in the next, in ferns, the leaf shows circinate venation. So, circinate venation means long leaves are coiled inwards. So, in this picture, it is clear that circinate venation, these are the very long leaves, these are being coiled inwards. And next, based on the leaf structure, pteridophytes are classified into microphyllous pteridophytes and macrophyllous pteridophytes. Coming to the microphyllous pteridophytes, simple leaves with single vein and no leaf gap is being formed. For example, Lycopodium. So, macrophyllous venation are so large pinnatified leaves having a complex series of veins and they form a prominent leaf gap in the stem steel. So, terrace. Next, stems are usually branched. So, the branching is monopodial or dichotomous. The branches do not arise from the axils of the leaves. The leaves and stem possess trichomes. So the stomata are present on both the surface of the leaves. The root and stems are well-developed vascular system. So the vascular system has been composed of xylem and phloem. The cambium is absent. So hence the secondary thickenings is absent. So some pteridophytes show secondary growth. So isotes. So the vascular elements are well developed in pteridophytes. The progressive advancement of vascular structure in different groups are being seen. So the vascular structures are commonly called it as steel. So the steel may be protosteel, example in Lycopodium, siphonosteel, equistem, so dictosteel, teres, polysteel, angiopteris. Next, xylem is made up of trachytes. So the phloem is made up of sieve cells and phloem parenchyma. So the xylem vessels are absent. The xylem conducts the water and minerals. The phloem conducts the food materials. So the photosynthetic tissue mostly restricted to the leaves. There is no tissue differentiation in the microphyllous leaves. In megaphyllous leaves, the palisade and spongy differentiation is being seen. And next, reproduction. So pteridophytes reproduce by spores. The spores are produced in sporangia. So we all know this. The sporangia are borne on the ventral side of the leaves. So the sporophyll, leaves on which the sporangia are produced, we call it as sporophyll. So opisoglossum, so fertile spike bearing sporangia arise from the axile of the leaves. So in aquatic forms, Salvinia and Marsilia, the sporangium are present within the specialized structures which we call it as sporocarps. So this is Marsilia and this is Salvinia. So we can see the sporocarps in a specialized structures. So the plants may be either homosporous or heterosporous. So for the homosporous, the examples are Lycopodium and Pteris. For the heterosporous, the examples are Selaginella. Next, homosporous. The single type of spores are present and sporangia. Spores are very small. Heterosporous. There are two types of spores and sporangia. So one is large and the other one is small. So large sporangia, megasporangia is produced, female megaspores, small sporangia, microsporangia will produce male microspore. So in this picture we can able to see, so this is the megasporangium, this is the microsporangium and this is the megasporangium. So we can look, the megasporangium is very big and the microsporangiums are very small. So there are two types of sporangia based on their development. Eusporangiate and leptosporangiate. Eusporangiate is being developed from a group of initial cells. Leptosporangium developed from a group, single initial cell. So eusporangia is from group, leptosporangia is from single. So this is eusporangiate, this is leptosporangiate. So coming to the sporophyll may be either aggregate into compact cone, which we call it as stroboli, at one end of the stem. So this is nothing but cone or stroboli. So uniformly distributed, or so it may be aggregated or uniformly distributed. So this is equistem, this is Selaginella, this is Osmunda, this is Lycopodium. So, in a true form, the sporangia located on the lower surface of the leaf in clusters, which we call it as sori. So, in this picture, we can see the lower surface of the leaf, the spores are being located. So, the spore wall is very thick, differentiated into outer exine and inner intine. The spores germinate to form a gametophytic generation. The homosporous species, development of the gametophyte is exosporic, means the gametophyte developed outside the spore wall. So in the heterosporous species, the development is endosporic, means the gametophytic developed within the spore wall. So the gametophytic and sporophytic are two separate and independent plants. No physical connection between the two generations are present in pteridophytes. Coming to the next, so the much variation in the gametophyte among the different species. So the gametophyte we call it as prothallus, means thallus-like morphology. So in homosporous type, the prothallus is simple, green and heart-shaped. So in homosporous species are monoecious. We have the Antheridia and Archegonium are born on the same prothallus. So this is the young sporophyte. So this is the prothallus. And the next, heterosporous type is always dioecious. So the microspore gives rise to male prothallus, the megaspore gives rise to female prothallus. So the sex organs are embedded or projected in the prothallus. The antheridium is being surrounded by a sterile jacket. So the jacket is always single layered. The antheridia are sessile or short stacked. So anthrozoids, these are the unicellular spirally coiled with two apical flagella. So Archegonia is being differentiated into neck and venter. So the neck is projected and the venter is embedded in the prothallus. So the neck cells are degraded to produce mucilaginous substances. So the mucilage will attract the anthrozoids towards the Archegonia. The water is essential for fertilization. Eggs and anthrozoids fuse to form a zygote. So the zygote is the first cell of sporophyte. So the zygote will develop to form embryo. So from the zygote, which is a diploid. So always the diploid is the sporophytic stage and the haploid is gametophytic stage. The first division of zygote will determine the polarity of the embryo. So if the base pole will form the foot and the roots, apical pole will rise to shoot apex. So the pteridophyte shows typically heteromorphic alterations of the generations. Morphologically distinct sporophytic and gametophytic generation. Main plant body is sporophyte, which is a dominant phase. Separate and independent gametophytic and sporophytic generations are being seen. So this is the life cycle of pteridophytes. First, sporophyte. So the sporophyte is being after the sporophyte, it will develop into microsporophyll and megasporophyll from this. So this microsporophyll and mega, these are the two separate plants in heterosporous condition. In homosporous condition, only single type will be present, which will develop into prothallus. Here we have the separate prothallus and which gives rise to microsporangium and megasporangium. So these will undergo meiosis to develop into microspore and megaspore. So these will fall and separately and develop into male gamete and female gametophyte. So next, so the male gametophyte will develop into antheridium and archegonium. So anthrozoites and egg. So later on fusion, which will give to zygote. And here from here, the sporophytic stage will start. It develop into embryo, young sporophyte, and again the mature sporophyte. Again the cycle will repeat. So here the dominant phase is nothing but sporophytic generation. So we have a separate plant for this. There is no any dependent, like gametophyte should be on the sporophyte or the sporophyte should be on the gametophytic plant. There is nothing like that. These will be in a separate plant system. So it will fall and it will develop into a separate things. So these spores. So these spores will fall in separate microspore and megaspore. So we have a separate generations and alterations of the generations can be seen. So thank you very much. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel.